Well, good morning, church family. It is Wednesday, April the 22nd, and I hope you are doing well this morning and praying for you today, thinking about you, wanting you to know that God loves you and that He is here in the midst of our circumstance, and He is here in the midst of what we are going through. Today's devotion is in the same passage we were in yesterday. It's in Isaiah 43, but actually it's just verse 1 today. And it says this. I'll read it to you and then we'll jump into it, the truth of today. It says in Isaiah 43, verse 1, it says, "But now thus says the Lord, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. Fear not. I have redeemed you." That's what we talked about yesterday, about God adding value to you, or placing the value upon you because of what He did with His Son Jesus. And through Jesus dying on the cross and raising again, and the love that God has for you and for me, He valued you as important as His Son. I mean, it's crazy. So He adds value upon you. We talked about that yesterday, being redeemed. But today, I want to tell you this. The truth is, God knows your name, and you are His. Think about that for a second. God knows your name. 7.5 billion people in this earth, and God knows your name. He knew you. The creator of the universe, the creator that breathed life into everything that we see, who breathed life into you and into me, knows your name. Knows you, your full name. He knows who you are. Every single part of you, He knows. He knitted you, He formed you, He knew you before you were even born. He knows your name. Now, what does that mean? Now, I want to just relate this to my life. For those of you that don't know, I have a younger sister named Christy. And whenever we were teenagers, whenever our mom got upset with me, and with me a lot, no, I'm just kidding. But whenever mom would call and she would get excited or whatever, it probably was whenever she was upset with us. But anyway, she would be talking to me and be like, "All right, Christy, Shad." And we would give her the hardest time about knowing, you know, who we are. I would be like, "Hey, I'm Shad. I'm your son." And Christy would be like, "You know, we should put name tags on us and stuff like that during the day." And we just gave her a good time about that. Well, now I am 47. I have a 18-year-old son named Caleb. He's a senior in high school. I have a 17-year-old daughter named Lily, who's a junior in high school. And I do the exact same thing to them. But it's not even when I'm excited. When I'm just sitting talking to her, or to them. A couple nights ago, I was talking to Lily, just sitting on the couch talking to her, and I was telling her something. Then I said, Lily, like that. And she looked at me and she goes, "Dad, I'm Lily. I'm your daughter." I was like, "I know who you are." But the crazy part about it is that's two children that sometimes I don't get their names wrong, but Lily, and I hope you do that too. I'm not the only person in the world that does that. But think about that for a second. I have two children and I do that. And I know their name, but I kind of do that. God never does that. 7.5 billion people, and He never does that to you or to me. Do you know why? Because He knows us. He created us. He knows your name. You and I am His. We are His. And so I just want you to think about that today. What does that mean? And what that means is God knows where you are in life. God knows what's going on with you. God knows your emotional state. God knows your physical circumstances. God knows the stress and the anxiety that's going on in your life. God knows that you lost a job. God knows that you're nervous every day. You're waking up trying to figure out how to teach your kids, homeschool stuff. God knows because He knows your name. You are His. And so today what I want you to do is I want you to just sit back and think about that. Let that resonate with you all day long. He knows my name. And I want you to find strength and comfort in that. He knows my name. He knows your name. Because the God who knows your name will take care of you because you are His child, because you are His, because we are His. And so I want to encourage you today with that. Just think about that. What does it mean that the God of the universe, the God that breathed life into all of this, 7.5 billion people on this earth, and He knows your name. That's special. That's a special God who loves you and who cares for you and who will see you through this. I love you. I'm praying for you today. And let's pray. And then we'll end this devotion. God, I just want to thank you for your Son, Jesus, and the grace and mercy that comes through Him. Lord, I want to pray for all of us. Lord, let us sit and just pause today as we realize that you know our name and that we are yours. God, give us the peace and strength that comes from that. Lord, let the anxiety just leave us because we know that you know our name and that you know us intimately. God, my prayer is for everyone that's listening to this. Lord, that today will be a great day for them. God, that they'll find hope in you and that they'll understand that this is only a season and that this too shall pass. Lord, I love you. Thank you for knowing my name. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you guys. I miss you, church family. I love you, and I hope you're having a great day today. Remember to turn up the volume of the truth of God's Word in your life. And then also remember that in Christ there is always hope. God bless you guys. I will see you tomorrow. God bless.